Hello YouTube, welcome back. It's Stardew Valley. We're going to start a Stardew Valley series, and I am going to call my farm Farmbeards. I think we'd all pretty much expected that, or at least anyone who's watched prior videos of these kind of games that I've done will definitely have expected. But, you know, that's how it goes. Let's start, shall we? Shall I turn this webcam off? Because it's looking very grainy today, isn't it? The light levels are just not high enough for me to do this. So, goodbye for now. I'll see you at the end. Toodlepip. And we'll do this just game... and you and me. That didn't make any sense, did it? That was just me babbling away when I didn't need to. Here we go. So, I think obviously we've got to put my name in here. Much as it would be nice to get the viewers in here, I think that's going to have to happen in the form of farm animals. It's not really going to work if we make me somebody in the chat, is it? It's going to be stupid. It's ridiculous. Let's call our farm Farmbeards. There we go. Farmbeards, of course. A fine naming tradition started on my stream. I like it. I'm going to continue it. And my favourite thing. Oh my goodness. Now this is a conundrum. While we're here, I think I'll pick a dog. And we'll randomise the appearance a bit and see what have we got. Interesting. Green trousers, red top. Sort of 90s curtains haircut. I like that one. That's quite good. Skull t-shirt. Nice. Nice. No, I don't like that look. Look at that, it's got these weird sort of green lederhosen on. That's no good. Intriguing. Could go for the spiky hair. Ooh, quite the fro. Ah, the last one was actually quite good. Ah, never mind. Let's keep going till we see something decent. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Oh, my favourite thing. Beards? My favourite thing. Well, my favourite thing isn't beards. I mean, I quite like my beard. You know what? You know what? I think that's it. I think we're going to take this guy. Scoundrel's going to be like this. It's like me with just the moustache. No beard. Got the hair. It's all good. So my favourite thing. I don't know. My favourite thing. What could my favourite thing be? I mean, I'm not going to sit here and actually try and figure out what my favourite thing is. That would be ridiculous. What I'm going to figure out is what my guy in Farmbeards would like. Beard stroking. That actually works. Let's have some beard stroking in there. Ah, character limit. Oh, I can. How come I can't put a G in? But I can put in an apostrophe. What's all that about? Okay, it's going to have to be the apostrophe. Okay, beard stroking. That's what I like. Beard stroking. Shall we watch the intro? We may as well, seeing as I'm recording it. Let's get the full experience, shall we? Let's do it. Let's go. Now, I've seen this already. This is not my first run at the rodeo. Hang on a minute. I know what's going on here. This seems very somber, doesn't it? Because there's no music. Ah. Oh. For my very special grandson. Yes? Oh, here we go. I had to click on the screen to get it to go. Yes, Grandad, what? Tell me, Grandad. I want you to have this sealed envelope. Thank you. I appreciate it. There it goes. Pops into my inventory. No. Don't open it yet. Have patience. Okay, Grandad. Wait a minute, Grandad. What's this sword over the fire all about? I've never noticed that before. Now listen close. There will come a day when you feel crushed by the burden of modern life. Oh my goodness. I don't want to be crushed. And your bright spirit will fade before a growing emptiness. Oh my god. Grandad, this is a bit dark. Don't let these be your final words. When that happens, my boy, you'll be ready for this gift. Okay. Fair enough. When I feel the existential dread... existential dread creeping in, I'll be sure to open your envelope. 20 years later? Is that 20 or XX, like an indeterminate number of years? Are we talking Roman numerals here? I don't know. Join us and thrive at the Joja Corporation. Smile! You're with Joja. Or is it Hoha? Or Yo-Ya? I don't know. You could pronounce it any way you like. That guy there was licking his lips a little bit too vigorously. Here I am, sitting behind my desk. Scoundrel with a few charts up there on the wall. Oh, hang on a minute. Oh, I'm vibrating with sadness. That's not good. Look at that OS. Look at that mouse. Oh, my God. Oh, the letter. Granddad's letter. Dear Scoundrel, if you're reading this, you must be in dire need of a change. The same thing happened to me long ago. I'd lost sight of what mattered most in life, real connections with other people and nature. So I dropped everything and moved to the place I truly belong. I've enclosed the deed to that place, my pride and joy, Farmbeards Farm. It's located in Stardew Valley on the southern coast. It's the perfect place to start your new life. This was my most precious gift of all, and now it's yours. I know you'll honor the family name, my boy. Good luck. Love, Grandpa. P.S. If Lewis is still alive, say hi to the old guy for me, will you? Okay, Grandad. No problem. I get the feeling I'm clipping off the edges here. I might have to make some impromptu adjustments. Let me just move the chat for a second, and I'm going to have to maximize this screen. Let's, oh, here comes the bus coming into town. That handy arrow telling you where to get on and off. Yeah, we're definitely not getting the full picture here, are we? I think it's time to do the full-blown maximization. We're going to get some black bars at the side of the video, but I hope you'll forgive me for that. Half a mile? Come on. Let's get there now. Chop, chop. Oh, no. I'm bringing my city ways. I'm polluting the countryside with my impatience. And they're taunting me. They're essentially begging me to do it. Hello, you must be Scoundrel. Why, yes, I am, Robin. Hello. I'm Robin, the local carpenter. Mayor Lewis sent me here to fetch you and show you the way to your new home. He's there right now, tidying things up for your arrival. That's nice. The farm's right over here. If you'll follow me, I'll follow you. Oh, hello, Sergeant Indy. This is Farmbeard's Farm. Oh, my goodness. Quite right, Scoundrel. It is a bit of a mess, isn't it? What's the matter? Sure, it's a bit overgrown, but there's some good soil underneath that mess. With a little dedication, you'll have it cleaned up in no time. Delightful. That's just the thing I want to hear. Look, you know, this cutscene is all well and good, but maybe I'll skip it, because I have read it. And here we are, your new home. Thank you, Robin. That's not... Oh, here comes Mayor Lewis with his yellow tie and green shirt. Ah, the new farmer! Look at us with our little moustaches here. We're in the moustache club. Welcome. I'm Lewis, Mayor of Pelican Town. You know, everyone's been asking about you. It's not every day that someone new moves in. It's quite a big deal. That's nice, isn't it? Don't know if I'll be continuing doing that voice for him. So, you're moving into your grandfather's old cottage. It's a good house. Very rustic. Yeah, I like it. Plenty of firewood for winter. Rustic, that's one way to put it. Oh, look at her. She's cracking wise. She's making a joke. I can tell because she's got her hand up. Crusty might be a little bit more apt, though. Oh, my goodness. Rude! I don't care. It's not my house. Well, it is my house, but I've acquired it this way. It's not got this way through my neglect. That's not the case.
Don't listen to her, Scoundrel. She's just trying to make you dissatisfied so that you buy one of her house upgrades.
Ah. Oh, now she's upset.
Humph! Anyway, you must be tired from that long journey. You should get some rest. Tomorrow you ought to explore the town a bit and introduce yourself.
His accent, his little voice I'm doing is getting thicker and thicker.
The townspeople would appreciate that.
I'm not managing to keep it even. It's sliding into a new different caricature.
Oh, I almost forgot. If you have anything to sell, just place it in this box here. I'll come by during the night to collect it. Well, good luck.
Thank you very much, Mayor Lewis. But now... Now I'm going to create a stir. Ah, look at that. Has that changed the... Are we having vision issues here? Or has it correctly scaled? my progress has been saved. There we go. Look, that's much better, isn't it? Getting a much better view. Okay, so it's 6 a.m. I have 500 coins and my journal has a message. It would be a nice gesture to introduce yourself around town. Some people might be anxious to meet the new farmer. 2 out of 28 people greeted. Okay, well, we'll do that at some point. I've got 15 parsnip seeds. That's good. And another new journal entry. You received 15 parsnip seeds. Here's a little something to get you started. From Mayor Lewis. Or should I say, here's a little something to get you started. And there it is, a new entry in the journal called Getting Started. If you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on that tilled soil to sow a crop. Water every day until the crop is ready for harvest. Cultivate and harvest a parsnip. I think I can just about manage that, and because this is not my first time playing Stardew, I know to check the weather report and other such television programs. Welcome to Kozu 5, your number one source for weather news and entertainment. And now the weather forecast for tomorrow. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Ah, lots of watering for me then. Whoa! Oh, let's not pick the telly up. Let's check what the fortune teller's got to say. Ooh, I see a glimmer within my scrying orb. A shard of knowledge from the future. This is rare. The spirits feel absolutely neutral today. Oh, well, that's an unusual thing to hear from a psychic, but okay. Living off the land. Welcome to Living Off the Land. We're back again with another tip for y'all. Now listen up. This one's for all you greenhorns out there. Chop wood and search for wild forage to earn some cash while waiting for your first harvest. That's lovely. I already knew that, but okay. Let's get down to the action and let's check chat quickly because I'm ignoring it. Oh, yes. The chat have nicely and succinctly explained the origin of the beards thing. That's good. That's very good. That means I don't have to go over it again. Although, for those of you watching the video, of course, you will not have necessarily read what was going on in chat. It could have been difficult to see. I must admit, I didn't spend the right amount of time setting up this time, so perhaps I can be tarted up a bit for the next episode. But basically, I in any kind of game like this, like, say, Dwarf Fortress, we had Cryptbeards. Rimworld is Rimbeards. And this, of course, is Farmbeards. And that's my naming convention. So there you go. There's everything wrapped up in a little nutshell for you. Let's start by cracking out the pickaxe and breaking some of these rocks, because frankly, they're an eyesore. And they get in the way and yield me precious stone. I mean, I'm not entirely sure how precious stone is, to be fair. I've not actually built anything out of stone yet. Although I'm pretty sure trees grow back, so wood is nice and easy to come by. Bushes grow back, nice and easy to come by. Rocks, I'm not sure they grow back. That seems unlikely to me. Certainly, it would be geologically... I mean, sure, rocks do grow back over extremely long timescales, but we're talking on an agricultural timescale here. We're not talking about the formation of geodes and the creation of limestone deposits. We're talking timescales on which you can feed a human being. Indeed, a population. Oops-a-daisy, yes. Hit the wrong key there. Okay, so I think that's got rid of most of the rocks that are in our immediate vicinity. Let's quickly crack up some of these logs, and then we can get the scythe out and really get rid of some of these bushes, because they are a pain in the poo pipe. Okay. What lovely music as well. I need to move my webcam. I'm not using it, and it's right in the way of my energy meter, so I can't tell how much energy I have left. Not good. Okay. So, there goes a frog. There we go. Now, I'm going to leave some of this grass here. I'm not going to start taking out the grass wholesale straight off the bat, because I know it can be useful for feeding cows, and if you haven't got any grass, and other animals as well, you have to plant it. So, you know, and it's more expense that you don't need to spend. So let's quickly cut ourselves a nice area here. We'll get the hoe out and we'll dig some flower beds in this shape. Because at some point I'll get automatic sprinklers to go in the middle here and it'll make it nice and easy and I won't have to keep watering it. But for now, I just have to stand in the middle with my watering can and clickety-click all the way around. We've watered the garden. Isn't that lovely? Oh, of course, there's a mine. I forgot about the mine. Right, this should be enough garden to plant the parsnip seeds in, right? Let's start by planting a full top row. No? Okay, needs to move the mouse, not the farmer. Then the next row. And then this bottom row can come back the other way. Ah, poo. Just one empty. Never mind. Maybe if I hack at some of these bushes, we'll get a wild seed. Wild seed! I'm not sure why I decided to do that little outburst, but okay. Maybe this is the grass you get the seeds in, isn't it? Just cut a bit of grass. Not too much. Just give me some sweet seeds. Come on. Seed me up. No? Not getting any seeds. Okay, well, fair enough. Let's move on. We'll take this tree down as well. Just because I've got the energy to spare. Maybe I should trot into town. I can buy some more seeds, actually, now that I think about it. If I don't muck around, I can get myself a nice collection of seeds. Currently got two slots of my inventory empty. Ah, but that's not going to last long, is it? Here comes some kind of forage. What do we got? It was a leek. Okay, that's good. Anything up here? Yeah, we got some tulips. That's right, I can sell these two things I've just picked up to free up the inventory slots when we get to the shop, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. Evening Skate 1985. I just glanced over at chat. I don't know how long you've been there, so I apologise if you've been waiting on me.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Harvey, the local doctor.
It's good to meet you, Doctor. Let's see what else you've got to say for yourself.
I perform regular checkups and medical procedures for all the residents of Pelican Town. It's rewarding work.
That's nice to know.
I hope you'll find your own work equally rewarding in time.
So do I. No more chat? Okay, fair enough. We'll tap out your options and let you go on your way. Now, the shop's over here, and of course, here's the notice board that tells you when everybody's birthday is. Let's have a look. Of course, it's Mayor Lewis's birthday first. I have to talk to him and figure out what he likes and give him a present, because I know that makes people sweet on you. So we've got a whole week before anything time-based happens. Let's pop in here. Stop swinging the axe, scoundrel. What are you doing? Okay, we've got some people to talk to, but first, let's talk to old shopkeep here, because we do not... What am I doing? There we go. Eat this leek. No, don't eat the leek. No, don't eat the leek! Okay, let's try holding something else. How about the sap? Can we talk to you now? There we go. We talked to him. We talked to him. We can get him. Now, I could buy some more parsnip seeds. However, I feel like buying a crop that has multiple harvests is going to yield more money in the end. So I'm going to go for... I mean, unless somebody in the chat has... hello, Super Chaser. If anyone in the chat has suggestions for crops I should grow, I'm quite happy to do that. I'm going to have to change the bot thing as well. Damn it, I keep forgetting to change that. Sorry, Super Chaser. See, I'm doing it all right tonight. It's not a problem. Kizu. Apologies, YouTube viewers who are unaware of what that's all about, but we just had someone turn up in chat, and I have to sing his name. I don't know why. It just happens. Let's get some beans in, shall we? Oh, no, we've got the full inventory. First, we sell that and that. He won't buy anything else. He'll buy the sap. We can free up another inventory slot. Let's do it. Let's sell the sap. We're going to get plenty more. There's trees all over the shop. None of this is saleable, so let's buy some beans. Four seems good. That leaves me with 372 gold. Cauliflowers are expensive. Do they yield a valuable crop? I don't know. Potatoes have the bonus of being able to give you multiple in one harvest, so I am going to take some potato seeds. Now, we could buy some flowers, some kale seed,
jazz seeds.
And there's that grass starter where I was mentioning that I didn't want to cut all the grass down because you have to replace it. Look at that, 100 gold a whack. Is that just one square of ground as well? I don't know. And all these are cooking ingredients, which get ridiculously expensive, and the trees as well, which are a bit out of my reach. But while we're waiting, so I've got potatoes. And you know, I've not grown a cauliflower before. I'm going to buy one. Oh, actually, that means I have to buy more cauliflower or more potatoes and beans. Let's get five beans. Nope. Six beans. And then we'll get another lot of potatoes. And that leaves us with 20 gold, which we can probably do about nothing. And we can't even buy parsnip seeds because we don't have the inventory space. Never mind. Although it would be nice to get one more part. Ah, no. Sorry. Let's get on with things. And have a chat with these guys. I guess everyone has different tastes. That's true.
Hello, it's nice to meet you. You picked a good time to move here. The spring is lovely. Good to know, Leah. Leah or Leah? I don't know which one it was. How about you? What do you want to talk about? Carolyn. Hello, you must be Scoundrel, the new farmer. I'm Carolyn. Well, that's good to know, Carolyn. My husband runs the general store here. And have you met my daughter, Abigail? She's the pale one with the purple hair. I'll keep an eye out for her so I can say hi. I don't think we've got access to their house yet, so we'll just leave that alone. Now that is a backpack which I want to purchase, but I have to save up 2,000 gold. Oh, hello, there's a little question mark here. What's that? Oh, it's gone. Never mind. Let me just have a quick... hold your sword when walking around. Oh, okay. Oh, grass starts for a huge patch of grass, so that's good. I'm just going to have a quick, while no one's looking, rummage through the bins. Make sure there's nothing exciting here. Oh, I can't take it. I've got to go plant these seeds, actually, thinking on it. It makes no sense to rummage through bins when you can't take anything home. I appear to have, sort of, breasts. I don't know if that's just supposed to be a light patch on the t-shirt or something, but it gives the impression of chesticles. Oh well, never mind. It's not a huge problem. I can deal with that. Just seems odd to combine that with a moustache. Let's put the lone cauliflower seed down here. And then, I haven't actually got a sword yet to walk around with now that I look. Then we'll go back to the hoe and we'll dig some more flower beds. Flower beds? No, I mean proper agricultural growing beds. Ah, for figgins fugs. Whoa, don't do that. Crikey, I'm digging up the plants again. Okay, so I'm going to put some bean poles here. Oh, what am I doing? Here. Oh my god. Here. 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 And here. Oh, there's one more. Here. And then we'll take the taters and place the taters here and here. And then we have to dig out some more space. Huh, okay. We've only got one more slot to do, so I'll just do that. Pop in the seeds and then we're done. Good. Now, it's watering time. Let's start with this one then. There we go. And then we can go on here. Ah. Water, water. That's good. Don't know if I'm going to get all this done with one watering can, but we'll soon find out. Yep, it looks like we will. Hooray! Everything watered. Now, we've got a little bit of energy left, so we can either invest that in walking around for some forage. It's 5 o'clock p.m. Or we can clear some more space. Frankly, seeing as we don't actually have any more seeds to plant, clearing more space seems like a waste of energy. We're going to have a walk around and see what we can find. See if we can fill up our four free inventory slots. Already looked up there. We know there's nothing for forage there. I'm pretty sure I chose male in the beginning. I think so. We'll see. Oh, hello. We've got some people down here to talk to. They look like the young'uns of the town. Let's have a chat. Let's get you before you run away. It's Shane.
I don't know you. Why are you talking to me?
Oh. Just being sociable, sir.
Oh, hey, so you're the new guy, huh?
Cool.
Thanks, Alex.
I'll see you around.
Well, that was blunt. Fair enough. Who are these two young ladies on the bench? Let's have a chat. Penny.
Hi.
Oh, did you want something? Just a little chat, that's all. What about you?
Maru.
Oh, aren't you the one who just moved in?
I am.
I'm Maru. I've been looking forward to meeting you. Hooray! You know, with a small town like this, a new face can really alter the community dynamic. It's exciting.
Ah, I'll talk to you later. Okay, what have we got down here? Anything exciting? Is this somebody's house? We could have gone into the bar there, but we'll leave it a little bit later. It's only 6:30. It's not quite drinking time. What am I doing? Why am I watering stuff? Let's walk around with the rock over our head. It may appear threatening to people we come across, but
It's better than spending all our energy fruitlessly pouring water onto the ground. Oh, hey, found the beach. Ah, there's normally some shells here, but unfortunately it doesn't look like any of... Ah, I spoke too soon. Here we go. What do we got? A cockle. A clam. And nothing else. Okay. Now that needs like something like 300 wood to repair, doesn't it? Let's have a look. Hmm. With 300 pieces of wood, this could be fixed. Sounds good. Let's do it. That walking into the boat there was actually me looking at chat. If you'd excuse me, I'm just going to glance over and... Bearded Lady Farmer Scoundrella. I suppose that could be a name. Hello, who's this? This looks like someone who knows what he's doing. Clint. Okay, Clint, tell me what's up. I've already given Clint a gift today. What? No, don't give him a plank of wood. Oh. Hi, I'm Clint. That's nice to know. I want to talk to you, not give you wood. Ooh. I'm the town blacksmith. If you ever need to upgrade your tools, I'm your guy. That's good to know. I will need those upgraded at some point. Who lives in this little shack? It's locked. Open 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Okay. Oh, it's 8 p.m. now. It's just shut. I feel like this little hunt has been fairly fruitless. I'm going to head back to town. Or back to farm, rather. Oh, no. We're going to the bar. We'll check out the Stardrop Saloon. It's about the time there should be people in there, right? Who we got here? Well, there's the blacksmith. Who we got at the end of the bar?
Hey, kid. The name's Pam.
Nice to meet you, Pam.
Hey, kid. I'd buy you a drink if I could afford it.
Nice to know. Oh, no. That's all she's interested in saying.
Well, hello there. I'm Gus, chef and owner of the Stardrop Saloon.
I don't know why I've given him a sort of faux American accent.
Hi there, scoundrel. I'm glad to see you. You're always welcome here.
Okay, that's not working well, is it? It's a terrible accent. The people in the bar just keep talking.
Ooh, I can read it on your face. You're going to love it here in Pelican Town.
Thank you, Emily.
If you're ever looking for something to do in the evening, stop by the saloon. That's where I work.
I am in the saloon, so, and it is the evening, so, okay. Actually, it's not the evening, it's night time. Who's this shady fella? Won't talk to me at all. Blimey. Now, I could play these arcade games, but I've played them previously, and I don't think they're going to be that exciting for the stream viewers. Yes, I'm wooing the townsman with hardwood references.
Check out this mahogany.
Is that a hardwood? I don't know. I remember being told the definition between hardwoods and softwoods, and I know that balsa wood is somewhat ironically a hardwood, but... I can't remember the actual definition. It might be something to do with the time it takes to grow. Who knows that? Right, it's getting dark. Let's head for bed. We know tomorrow is going to be a sunny day, so we're going to have to water the plants, but that's okay. We can live with that. I did start a new game, yeah. What's the weather report say? Welcome to Kozu 5, etc, etc. It's going to rain all day tomorrow. Hooray! No need to water anything. Let's go and talk to the fortune teller.
Welcome back to Wellwick's Oracle. If you seek hidden knowledge of the future, well, you've come to the right place. The spirits are in good humor today. I think you'll have a little extra luck.
Okay, I don't know why I'm putting on a weird ghost voice there, but okay. What? Ah, chop the axe. Wasted my first piece of effort. Can I? Talk. Can I choose this letter? Is that a thing? Is that an option? There we go.
Advertisement. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Does this sound like you? Well, Pierre's got you covered. Stop by Pierre's general store today and check out our affordable size 24 backpack. See you soon.
Okay, that's a grand though. No, 2 grand even. It's a little bit much for me. I can't really afford it.
Hello there.
Oh, that's no, this is from Willy, isn't it?
Hello there! Just got back from a fishing trip. You should come down to the beach sometime. I've got something for you.
Willy. Who disappointingly has more than one eye. Now, actually, I'll take this... I won't put this in my chest. I'll take the cockle and clam down to Willy and not only claim my fishing rod, but also sell my beach forage. I think that's a phrase. Beach forage. Right, 22 gold, not much use at the moment for buying. Let's head straight down to beach and say hi to Willy. Gotta get me some sweet Willy action. Ah, this music is so relaxing, it's nice. I've got to be careful to keep an eye on the time, because I might relax right past bedtime, and that would be no good. Here he is, Willy in his pipe, tapping his toe, thinking a sea shanty. A life on the open wave. There's Willy.
Ahoy there, son. Heard there was a newcomer in town. Good to finally meet ya.
Well, thank you, Willy. I'm glad to meet you too. Excuse me.
Yar, I'm still trying to unwind from a month out on the salty seas. It was a big haul. I sold a lot of good fish. Finally saved enough to buy me a new rod. Here, I want you to have my old fishing rod.
That's interesting. Just give it to the new guy as he moves into town.
It's important to me that the art of fishing stays alive. And hey, maybe you'll buy something from the shop once in a while.
Maybe I will. Then again, maybe I won't, Willy. That's the nature of uncertainty.
You received a bamboo pole.
That's good. I like having bamboo poles. They make a good swishy noise as you whip them through the air.
There's good weather here in the valley. All kinds of fish.
Weather? That's water. But okay. Okay, this cutscene's dragging on, Willy. I don't mean to be rude, but shut up.
Oh, yeah. My shop's back open now.
Yeah, there's a blind break there.
So come by if you need supplies.
I will do.
I'll also buy anything you catch.
Thanks, Willy.
If it smells, it sells. That's what my old pappy used to say anyway. And he was a pimp.
No, no, that's a terrible joke. I shouldn't have said that. Let's have a sip of water. I've kind of buggered my voice with the old pirate words. Looking down like this, now my boobs can't be seen, but this reveals the moobage. I don't want to use the language of the youth of today out of turn, but these boobs be whack, yo. Let's head into the fish shop. Locked. 9 to 5. Willy. I never knew sailors were 9 to 5ers too. Okay, I'll come back in a bit. I mean, I could fish for an hour. It's not that long, is it? Let's fish off the pier. Let's see how we can do. Nope, not quite. But quite high anyway. Not the worst cast it could have been. I'm not very good at the fishing in this, it has to be said. Okay. Ah, there we go. Here comes the fish. Right. Oh, this one's easy. It's the tutorial fish. Curse you, tutorial fish. You lure me into a false sense of security. A 1-inch sardine. Okay. Let's try going over here. We've only got 20 minutes to wait. Oh, look. Willy's off to the shop. Oh, I missed it. Ah, pants. Oh, well. Let's go buy some stuff off Willy. Oh, no. That's the wrong thing to do. Hey, Willy. How's it going? Right. Trout soup for 250 gold. No. And a bamboo pole for 500 gold. Why would I want that? You just gave me one for free. Right. The clam is worth 50 here, and the cockle is worth 50 here. I believe they're worth the same in the shop, but... Maybe they're not sellable in the shop. Whatevs. We want the money, and therefore the seeds we can get from that money. 162 gold will go towards a fine haul of small growing pellets. Let's head back. Ah! Another clam. We can actually check to see if it's sellable in the shop and the price we get from putting it in the box. Because now we know it's 50. That's good news. Okay, so more stuff's been washed up. We've got that. Shop, I think. That's probably the best bet. Into Pierre's. And good, he's behind the counter.
Hello!
Yeah, you can't sell them there, so I'll put them in the box and see what they're worth. Right. Well, I'm thinking... we could get some flowers, I suppose, see what they're like. I mean, they're worth 50 a pop when you grow them, so it's a 20 gold profit on each one, but really, takes 7 days to produce a blue puffball flower. 6 days, 6 days, 6 days, 12 days, 10 days, 4 days. Parsnips come up quite quick. I'm going to try some jazz seeds and probably going to buy some more bean starters. We want to get them in early, don't we? Start them off while we're still good. 9:50 a.m. still. We've got some time to go back and plant these. That's good. That's what we want. I see there's a small amount of controversy in chat over whether the fishing minigame was good. It's frustratingly difficult. I'll reserve judgment. It's a squirrel. Can we talk to the squirrel? No. Can I shake the tree? Hey, squirrel. Oh, not with that. Idiot. Squirrel, squirrel. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, hey, squirrel, squirrel, hey! No, squirrel's not interested. I've not actually had the guts to chop one of these trees out here down, actually, because I was worried that they might be... let's refill the watering can. Actually, let's water these before we start planting more. Get in the middle. And there we go. That's one lot. And then get these lot up. Oh, out of water. Okay, let's refill. Oh, the trees grow back. Oh, that's okay then. Not an issue. I'll start chopping down more trees in the local area then. Never know. Maybe they've got something hidden in them. Okay, and we've got one more there, and that's everything previously planted, been watered. Shite, didn't want that one. But luckily I know that you can dig it back out with the pick. There we go, and in here we will put... two more bean seeds, yep. And the jazz can go right there. Good. And let's water all the noobs. There we go. Beautiful. Okay, we've still got plenty of time and energy. Still not going to clear the farm out anymore. Not worth it. Oh, but I am going to put that in my chest. And it might be a good idea to start harvesting some wood, actually. I'm just going to chop that squirrel tree down out of pure curiosity to see if the squirrel is available. Or available? See if it comes out of the tree. I'm not going to proposition the squirrel. Excuse me, are you taken? I have a penchant for small furry rodents with fluffy tails. Would you like to become my furry wife? No, I don't think that's the best way to approach a squirrel. Okay, I'm going to try chopping down one of these pink leaf jobs. I've not done that before. Is it a different kind of wood? A better kind of wood? It's unchoppable! Huh. That's a major disappointment. Okay, got nothing to sell. So maybe I'll chop some trees on my own land then. Although I should really be out and about foraging. I've got a relatively lucky day. That's a very good point. Let's go down instead of... I know there's stuff down here, so we'll drop a tree or two on the way. Come on, out of the way. There we go. Let's get down as low as we can. Go through the long grass. Jesus Christ, it's Boulder City. Okay, here we go. Wow, am I using up more health by using the wrong tool to cut those down? I think I am. Not health, you know. Energy, that's the word. Okay, let's explore down here. What does the sign say? Stop hitting things, scoundrel, for Christ's sake! Farm and Pelican Town, okay. Well, we'll have a little forage around here first, see what we can find. Ha! And we've paid dividends. There we go, we've got a wild horseradish. Exactly what we wanted. Anyone down here? Could fish in that pond, but I'll leave it for now. See if we can find any more of nature's bounty. The wonderful... Oh, hello, rabbit. No, stop... Are we supposed to shake the bushes? Is that a thing?
Does that reveal items? We'll see. Maybe later on in the summer they'll have fruit or something and you can knock it off. There we go, another wild horseradish, all good. It's down here. Okay, this looks pretty rough. I don't know what that is. Some kind of... Is that the mudslide that Jojo Mart tell you they've cleared later on? It looks like it. There's bottles and other rubbish down there. Oh, hang on. Ah, inventory full. I suppose we could chuck the fibre. We don't really need it, do we? Can I even chuck it? Yeah. Didn't do that. Pick up the flour, which is much more valuable. Let's have a look around. It's 4:40. We could go and sell what we've got already and come back out and have a look, but yeah, I suppose so. That makes sense. The path up seems to be the sensible path to take. Oh, hold on a minute. It's a little bit twisty, a little bit turny, taking me strange ways. Trees can yield their relative seed. Oh, that's pretty good. Oh, hang on. Nearly missed that, looking at chat. Okay, back up here. Some more rickety bridges. Nothing up here. Oh, we've got someone's house. Who lives here? It's locked. Only Leah's friends can enter uninvited. Oh, okay. Shake a couple of bushes. No. Nothing? Okay. Excuse that little snort there. Okay, 6 o'clock p.m. I think the shop's going to be shut anyway. Oh, hello, hello. No, let's have a conversation. Who are you? Hi. Is that it? I'm tutoring Vincent and Jazz today. They're a handful, but it's nice to make a difference in someone's life. Well done, Penny. So noble. Carry on. Got no inventory spaces, so again, it's pretty pointless going through people's bins. But never mind. Never mind, we'll get a chance. Sometime soon, I'll be going through people's bins. Wild onions to the south. Oh, I missed that. Poop. Well, I might have time to get down there. It's 6:40. Oh, no, it's a bit of a roundabout route, actually. It's probably best just to put this stuff in the box. And what have we got? Should we get rid of the horseradish? The dandelion? Oh, I can plant the mixed seeds. Maybe I'll get rid of the sap. Yeah, let's get rid of the sap. I don't really need it. Okay, let's put the wild seeds down and water them. What have we ended up with? Don't know, can't tell. Intriguing. Right, what's left to do? I've got a bit of energy. I could chop some more trees down and gather wood because, you know, wood is a fairly useful resource. I could start crafting and get my way towards making a chest. Requires 50 wood. Well, I've got 42, so 50 is not an unreasonable target. Let's chop this tree down and see what it gets us. Oh, ah, butterflies. How lovely. Apart from the fact that I only saw them because I destroyed their habitat. Okay, 54. Let's see if we can build a chest. It's a real game changer, the chest. Means I've got a few more... Ah, look at that. Chest. Lovely. Lovely. Let's place that chest outside, and now we don't have to sell everything immediately. There we go. Oh, don't hit it. Crikey. Put the stone in there, put the wood in there. Sap we don't have to sell. I'm going to put the bamboo pole in there, because I'm not really using it most of the time. And that looks good, right? That's good. Okay, we're good. That's very good. Actually, yeah, she says she was tutoring two kids, but there was only one there. That is a bit weird. Right, may as well use up the rest of my energy clearing out some more of this stuff before I go to sleep. Scythe. Oops. No point going to bed when there's work to be done if I've got a full health bar. Oh, I should also fill up my watering can while I'm down here. There we go. More scythe action. Oops-a-daisy. Let's take out this little tree. We don't want that growing up to be a big one. Not here, anyway. Okay. Get rid of of these little ones as well. There we go. It's looking like a nice, tidy little space now. All the wood you could want. I'm starting to feel exhausted, am I? Okay, probably time to call it a night then. 9:30, farmer's bedtime. Hello, Fuzzy Logic. Excuse me. Okay. Let's go to sleep for the night. Why ever not? Why wouldn't I? So, foraging. Oh, does it tell me how much I got for each thing? Yes, 50 gold. So, yeah, you get the same price no matter if you sell it or put it in the box. So putting it in the box seems to make sense. Total of 252 gold. Well, you know what that says to me? That says seeds, because the third day of spring still seems to be a good day to plant stuff. It's not getting too late that things won't be harvestable. So let's get out of bed. Hear that rain? No more watering today. What does the weather report say about tomorrow, though? It's going to rain all day tomorrow as well. Hooray! Ah, I sense that a new viewer has joined us. A young man from Stardew Valley. Welcome, welcome. The spirits feel neutral today. The day is in your hands. That's good to know. Thank you very much, Television Psychic. Not normally one to trust Television Psychics, but oh well. Wait a minute, did that just grow up overnight? Crikey. Okay, so we're going to head out and grab some more seeds, I think. First, oh, actually, if we head out straight away, we won't get to the shop. Oh, sorry, the shop won't be open when we get there. So let's chop down this tree. Because it... Ooh, what was that noise? Ooh! Some kind of weird... Ah! Well, I'm glad Stardew Valley doesn't penalise you for knocking trees down on your crops. That could have been a problem. There we go. Bip bop, bip bop, bip bop. Down comes the tree. Ah, lovely. Mm-mm. 44 wood. Let's pop it in the chest. Okay. Building up a nice little stock of stuff. I might have to get it out and see what I can build, if I can build anything interesting out of it. There we go. Maybe I'll get some more fibre as well while I'm at it. Oh, that frog narrowly escaped the scythe. Okay. I think that'll do. Keep the coal as well. 56 wood. Could build another chest, but it seems a little bit early for that. What's in my crafting slot? Wood path, gravel path, cobblestone path, campfire. Provides a moderate amount of light. Is that good for plants, or is that just for decoration? I don't really know. Torch provides a modest amount of light. Well, I can build those. Let's get some torches out. Maybe I'll pop some in the middle. Hmm. Anyone in chat know what... know what torches are for? Let's go buy some seeds. The shop will be open by now. Oh, hello. Look at this. Oh, wow. Two leeks. Whoa! What is that, some kind of Bigfoot? I've heard that before in the game, but I've never actually figured out what it is. What's making those crazy noises? Oh, there's something on the notice board. Let's take a look. What have we got? The Egg Festival. Were they there before? The Egg Festival and the Flower Dance are now on the schedule. Ah, help wanted. Here we go. I have a craving for largemouth bass. Please bring one by for me. Please bring one... Oh, sorry. I have a craving for largemouth bass. Please bring one by for me. Pam. 300 gold on delivery. Makes Pam happy. Well, that's good. Who wouldn't want to make Pam happy? Isn't she a lovely lass? Closed on Wednesdays. Up your arse, Pierre. Up your arse. Nothing in the bin there. Nothing in the bin here. Nothing like a bit of urban forage to get the day going. No, nothing in your bin. Oh, we've got a flower though. That's good. A little bit of exciting discovery. What have we got over here? What's this? Closed until summer. Okay. Hello. Let's check the bin first. No, nothing in the bin. Ah, now, I'm not going to go there until I have something to put in, because I know what that is. That's the museum. You can put fossils and whatnot in there. 264, is that going to be enough to buy any blacksmith goods? Let's find out. Shop. Upgrade tools. Oh, no. We're going to need a couple of thousand for that. How about the shop? What have we got here? Copper ore, iron ore, coal and gold ore. Nah, don't think so, mate. Don't need it right now. Not much I can do with it. Torch just gives you light for night time. Ah, okay, I see. Okay, whenever I refer to Pam, I will always call her Pam! She's the local bar lady. She hangs around in the Joja Mart. I've not been in here before. Whoa. Crazy. Join us, thrive. Oops-a-daisy, nearly got him.
Welcome to Joja Mart. How are you doing today? I don't believe we've met. I'm Morris, Joja customer, satisfaction representative. When you decide you want to become a Joja member, I'll be delighted to help make your transition a joyous experience.
That's interesting. You can go fuck yourself, though. I'm not interested. Joja Cola, Joja Wallpaper, Jojo Jolite, Parsnip Seeds, Bean Starters. More expensive than Pierre as well. I don't get that. What's that all about? And pretty much just the same old. Nah, not interested. What are you all about, mate? Stuck in the shelves. Let's have a look.
Shane's hard at work. He doesn't seem interested in talking.
Ah, that's the guy who was surly before, and now we know why. Because he's a supermarket worker. Stocking shelves. He's not following his dream and being a farmer. Yeah, well, can I talk to you? No, you're not interested. Well, it's the last time I'll be wandering in there. With their crappy goods. Still in the morning, so that's good. Oh, look, there's someone over there I could have talked to if I'd been close enough. If only. Let's head over. Might be able to catch up, you never know. Might have stopped. They could be dilly-dallying, shilly-shallying, filly-fallying. Procrastinating. Ooh, flowers. Is there a way up down here, or am I going to have to go back up there? Nope, there's a way up. It's all good. Alright, let's get some more flowers, shall we? Bonus. Look at that. We're making some money. Unfortunately, we can't spend it today, but that's okay. Ah, look at this. Daffodils all over the place. Who doesn't love a good daffodil? Almost as good as dandelions. Anything growing up here? No. What's over here? 12:40 p.m. Ah, we got another big radish thing. Let's have that. Oh, it's a leek, sorry. This is the wild radish. Horseradish. What about up here? Ah, that's the mine. Not cleared open yet. Fair enough. Oh, that's a high quality. Look at that. That's an extra special leak. We might have to keep that for the fair. There's the old guy's tent. Can I get up here? No. Oh, blimey. That sounded like the start of some kind of crazy industrial music. Doom, 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 doom. Not seeing any forage here. It's all looking pretty bare. But we have made a pretty good haul today. I mean, look at this. This is probably my largest amount of money made in any single endeavour so far. And we get here, and we can clear some space. Oh, if we face the correct direction. And get some valuable work done on the farm. Oh, a geode. How delightful. Now, I know you're supposed to open them on lucky days, because it affects what comes out of them, so I'll save that for now. I can't remember if this is a lucky day or not. I think it's just a neutral one. Worms in the dirt? Oh, I missed the worms in the dirt. Damn. Oops, the inventory's full. Gonna have to do some chesting. What's all this woo-woo? Stone can go in there, wood can go in there, and the good quality leek. Actually, should I sell it? Is there some kind of rain whale? Is that what's happening here? Or is Grandad's ghost haunting me?
I'm watching you, scoundrel.
There we go, that's all that stuff sold. We'll make some money there. Okay, let's hack another tree down, get some more wood. It's afternoon now, so it seems a bit excessive to wander too far, and I think we've got enough forage. We're not going to have much more stuff to find, I don't think. Who knows though, maybe there will be. Maybe I'm missing a ton of stuff. Feel free to shower me with advice. This is all about a cooperative effort here. We're not going to be, struggle blindly if there's help available. Oh, cutting too much grass down. Calm down, scoundrel. That side's a little bit too efficient. Pop some more crap in there. Geode can go in too. It's just supposed to be nature. Is that some kind of natural sound then? I mean, yeah, natural if you're in the benthic zone at the bottom of the ocean. Ooh, ooh, goes the whale. I'm not sure there's much on land that does that.
Land whales.
Never seen a land whale. I refuse to believe they exist. There we go. Don't know why I needed to denounce the idea of land whales, but I did. Are any of these trees I'm cutting down actually going to yield any useful harvest? Am I... Oh, hello. We've got a little statue. I saw one of those elsewhere. What's this all about? It's unreactive. It has no interest. So we'll leave it for now. There's a little cave. Don't know what's in there. It's a shame I can't get some more seeds. It is raining again tomorrow, isn't it? Said the weather. So we'll be able to plant some stuff and get it all nicely watered then. No point digging out the beds too large before you actually plant in them, because they can just vanish, I've noticed, if they get left. So it's a bit of a waste of energy. 5:50 p.m. What's going on? Pardon me. I haven't seen Lewis for a while. What's he up to, I wonder? Better check up here. Did I check up here earlier? Must have done. Or there was just nothing there. That's the other option. Okay, I can't tap trees yet, so yeah, I'll just hack them up. Hack 'em up! Oh, hello, we've got some peeps. Ah, I saw you earlier. Let's have a chat, shall we? Oh, you just moved in, right? Cool. Thanks, Sebastian. Out of all the places you could live, you chose Pelican Town? I did. Well, I didn't. I kind of just got given a place in Pelican Town and just came here. Didn't really choose it. Looks like a good day to play catch, huh? No. I'd ask you to throw the ball around, but you don't really seem like the sports type.
I'm fine, just watching you from a distance.
Yeah, that's good, isn't it? I want to play catch with you. What's that supposed to mean? Are you saying that because I've got tits? Are you saying that people with tits can't catch? I think you'll find that's a wild, wild generalization. You sexist pig. Not that I'm a woman, mind. These are just boobs. Don't have to be a woman to have boobs. Ah, oh, what did I click? Shit. No! Damn. Screwed that one up, didn't I? My finger twitched, and it was all over. Let's check out the bar to drown our sorrows.
I need a little warm-me-up to be ready for another cold night on the ocean.
Okay, Willy. Alright. We know about your warm-me-ups. Let's warm up, Willie, shall we?
Remember to cover your mouth when you sneeze!
The
this morning, I accidentally stepped on a bug. Disaster.
Hey, kid. You're too young to be moping around in a place like this.
Okay, no, it's the same one again. Excuse me. God, Pam, you're a bit of a battering on the old voice box.
Hi there, scoundrel. I'm glad to see you. You're always welcome here. Yeah, these guys just repeat what they say, don't they? Can I actually buy anything here? I've heard rumours of rare and powerful magic rings forged long ago by forgotten civilizations. I'm not sure if it's true or just a fairy tale. Well, now that you've mentioned it, it probably is true, right? I mean, why would you mention it? Ah, we can buy. We can buy beer, salad, bread, spaghetti, pizza, coffee, hash brown recipe, omelette recipe. Oh, recipes. Yeah. Not yet, though. I'm saving this money for seeds. It's too early in the year to be spending money on recipes. We have not the ingredients. Anyway. Let's quickly check the bin. No discarded bread. Hey, how's it doing? Let's have a chat. Today would be a good day to explore the mines. Who knows? You might find some rare ores.
Where do I get my sword? Where do I get that? Let's have a look around. Pierre's ain't open today. It's 20 past 8. That makes it a little bit late for the mines, I think. But like I say, no sword, so... And also, the mines are blocked, as far as I remember, so not much chance of me finding much down there. Have I got time to make a quick trip to the beach? Give it a go, see if there's anything washed up on the shore. I mean, 50 gold for a clamshell's not to be sniffed at this early stage. Ah, here we go. 50 gold. Easy money. Ah, and it's a special edition. Special edition. That's not what I meant. You know what I mean. It's a superior specimen. Someone lived here once, it says about the clam. That's an interesting way of looking at it. Someone, something, a simple bivalve. A broken CD. Oh, excellent. How useful. I probably might use that to make some kind of bird scarer, couldn't I? Some kind of scarecrow? No more forage. Let's make it up back through the farm. It's 10 to 10. It's getting late. Okay. It's getting really late. There we go. That should be easier. Nope, can't get through here. There we go, I'm in. Right. Quickly let's put some of our booty in the for sale shop. Oh, actually, I don't want to sell the star thing, do I? I want to keep it until I know what I'm going to need for the fair. Can we sell the broken CD? May as well give it a crack. And let's keep the rest of the stuff, put it in the chest. And in we go. Time for bed at 10 to 11. Good night. Oh, I've leveled up. Level 1 foraging. Plus 1 axe proficiency. Trees sometimes drop seeds. New crafting recipe, wild seeds. Sp. New crafting recipe, field snack. That's good to know. So the 3rd of spring, year 1, I have gained 290 gold from foraging. And none from fishing, apparently. Apparently going through bins is fishing. Who knew? I certainly didn't. It's not raining. Maybe I got the weather forecast wrong. It's going to be clear and sunny all day tomorrow. The spirits feel neutral today. The day is in your hands. And Living Off the Land says... this one's for you folks living in Spring Onions, southwest of town, where the river meets the ocean. Okay. I have to go and find those. We'll start the day by... I won't go to the shop because... Should I just water this stuff then go to the shop? Yeah, I'll do it. There's water. Get it done.
Oh, this is so much less stressful than other games I've been playing lately. It's no Alien Isolation, for sure. There we go, that's all the beans watered. Well, actually it's not all the beans watered, we've still got two more beans. There we go, everything watered. I can refill the watering can. And we can go spend 554 gold on exciting things and stuff. Any forage up here? No. Any forage? Forage along the path? No. Oh, I see. Fishing telly before bed. Ah. Okay. That's interesting. I have to check for bedtime television. Oh, come on. 9? A whole hour to kill. Let's see if anyone's chucked anything out of their bins before everybody's up. This guy doesn't even have a bin. Whoever lives here does, though. Let's have a quick look. Maybe a contemplative stroll through the graveyard. What have we got on these gravestones? Let's have a look. It's old and faded. Our beloved Mona. Un op den judu putzen snausop hamp atode na du smolvu lonzol yen hut alai tol. What? Un op den judu putzen snausop hamp atode na du smolvu lonzol yen hut. Or late toll. Well, okay. Whatever that means. No, can't shout her through the bushes. That's okay. Let's quickly check to see if there's anything saleable washed up on the beach. It's nearly 9 o'clock. When we go back, we'll be able to sell stuff in the shop. Or rather, buy stuff. We haven't got anything saleable yet. And it looks like the beach is clamless. Oh, well. Never mind. Another day we shall find a clam. And it will be a wonderful day. Alright, let's head straight to the shop. Makes no sense to prat around here when there's shopping to be done. Oops, someone went into the doctor's. Okay, hello shopkeep. What do I want? Let's have a look. Well, again, ingredients. We've not really got the money for trees yet, so we're going to stick with... I don't think I'm going to plant any spring trees because they fade by summer, so I'll save up the money to buy stuff in summer. More parsnip seeds, more beans, more potatoes. Let's see. You know what? I'm thinking maybe some more beans. We're going to be selling... I want to make as much money as possible, and multiple harvests seems like it's the way to go. Right? Clam cram. Gus hid behind the pub to hide you. That's not cool. What a bastard. Bloody Gus. Should we get some kale? 6 days to mature. Harvest with a scythe. I'm going to get a load of potatoes, I think. Yeah. Don't feel like using my imagination. I'm just going to spend it all on taters and plant them. Seems like an easy money scenario, and I'm all about the easy money. Let's have a quick chat with old Doc, see what's going on. My God, it's not just a doctor's surgery. We've got medicine for sale. Energy tonic and muscle remedy. Ah, nice, okay. I don't think I can afford any of that at the moment, but once the crops start growing, oh yeah, that's when the money's going to start rolling in. But of course, first, I'll go for the backpack. We don't want to end up running around with just a single row of inventory squares. No, 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 no. We need to get to that 24-spot backpack as quick as possible. Okay, I'll quickly pop these taters in the ground, and then we'll start digging again. More hoe action, as they say. Oops, a daisy. Don't smack the beans. Hello, what was that? Clay. Okay. Don't really know if that's of much use, but great. There we go. Look at that. Ah, perfectly full planting beds. I love it. And there we go. Another circle of watering done. Lovely. Okay, everything's watered. We've got some clay. That's probably a keeper, isn't it? Let's haul all of our stuff out of here and see what we can build. We might have actually got some new options from the vast array of things available to me. Let's see. Crafting. I'll make a campfire. Meh. Torches, chest, gate, wooden fence. Do we need a fence yet? I've got no animals that can wander off. Actually, let's put all this stuff back in here. There we go. And let's take my full energy bar out and about to see what we can do. Any money to be had? Any financial rewards? No? Mm-hmm. Let me head down this way, I think, see what we can find. Oh, hello, Lewis! Lewis!
So, how was your first night in the old cottage?
It was fine. This is actually day four, mate, but good to ask.
Your grandpa used to complain about the rickety old bed, but I think deep down he actually loved that house.
I'm pretty sure he did. What, is that it? I can't talk to you anymore.
Lewis? Lewis?
It's not going to work. I can't talk to him. Hello? That looks like Penny. Let's have a word, see what Penny thinks. We're very lucky to have a library in such a small town. Yes, you are. When you're lost in a book, it's easy to forget the realities of your life. Maybe that's why I like reading so much. Sorry, I got carried away there. Great, it's nice. Fun fact, my first girlfriend was called Penny. Oh, what have we got here? Is this somebody's house? Have I just wandered into someone's house? Let's get out of here before we're accused of burglary. What have we got over here? Are we going back to Joja Town? Or am I very much mistaken? No, I haven't got anything to actually put in here. I'm not watching out for the wiggly worms. I should be keeping my eyes peeled, because every time I miss them, I'm losing vital opportunities to gain cool stuff. Especially the stuff for the museum. Okay. I've already been to the beach today, so I know there's nothing there of interest. I'm pretty sure I can't get into the sewer without some kind of key, so we're going to ignore that. Hey, I'm just standing next to this bin. Totally not going to go through it. Seriously, why would you think I'd do that?
Hey, I'm Sam. Good to meet you.
That's nice. Finally met Sam. Who are you? Come on. Spill the beans. Come on, little one.
It's Vincent. Oh, a stranger. My name's Vincent. Mama says not to talk to strangers, but you seem okay. Most paedophiles do.
That's how they do it. Took that to an exceedingly dark place on a hair trigger, didn't I? Should have probably stepped back and thought about that joke before I uttered it. Oh well. Never mind. And it's a, you know, not a necessarily true statement. It's a massive generalisation which doesn't account for people like Jimmy Savile, who anyone in their right mind should have probably clocked a lot quicker. Never mind. This is really not the best subject for Twitch. I'm not supposed to talk to strangers. Oh, look, she's got more sense than the boy. She just says, I'm not supposed to talk to strangers. Here we go, further down the coast. There's the Wizard's Tower. But I'm pretty sure I can't get in there until I can do something. What have I got to do? Oh, no, I can go straight up here.
It's locked. You can hear someone inside, though.
Okay, fair enough. Can't get in there yet. I either have to be invented. Invented? Invited? Or I have to complete some event to get the key. Anything more down here? Oh, there goes another squirrel. Yeah, not finding a whole heap of forage here. Looks abandoned. Oh, that's cool. Surely somebody lives there. Otherwise we can tear it down for wood, right? Makes sense to me. Ah! Oh, there's those spring onions everyone talks about. Look at this. Oh, yeah. And a dandelion. Just what the doctor ordered. Oh, hang on. Is that another one? Another spring onion. They're right. There's a lot of them down here. A bounteous harvest indeed. And a sewage outflow pipe. Yeah, not really interested in going up there right now. We'll wait until there's a more opportune moment, shall we? Some reason to wade in the sludge. Okay. Back north again. We've got all the spring onions. I wonder what they're worth. Doesn't say. Actually, I should probably hold on to some of this forage because I know I'm going to need it to complete the community centre quests. In fact, where is the community centre? It's not here. Whose house is this? Oh, it's Leah's house. Here we go. Ah, it's a farm. Oh, who's here? It's Marnie. Ah, Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie. I sell livestock and animal care products at my ranch. You should swing by sometime. Why not? I just have, actually. So, yeah. Swinging succeeded. Let's get up here. Oh. I'm on the south side of my farm. It's 6:20 and I've got a full energy bar. Let's have a little explore of the farm. I've not really looked around that much. I sort of just hung out where the farming's good. Okay, but is this the grass that's near our farm? No. Oh, blimey, there's actually quite a bit of farm that you have to clear. Wow. Oh, wow, we're all the way over here. Whatever this once was, it's now in ruins. There's some kind of ground over there. Let's see what this is over here. There's something behind this tree. Could be another one of those little shrines, couldn't it? Looks bigger than that, though. I can see something. That's it. Down it goes. Oh, what the funky dickens is this?
Scoundrel, wait for my return on the dawn of your third year.
Grandpa, what the hell? Grandpa's coming back from the dead. Grandpa, have you given me your old farm as part of some necromantic rite to bring you back from the dead? Are you going to sacrifice me? Not sure I trust you anymore, Gramps. This is on some kind of ancient burial ground, isn't it? Oh well, we're going to have to deal with that when it happens. We're going to have to build up our defences. We're going to need lots of stakes in case he comes back as a vampire. We're going to need, well, to be honest, just regular firepower tends to deal with most other returning forms of the dead, doesn't it? I mean, zombies. Let's hope he's a Night of the Living Dead type zombie rather than a Return of the Living Dead type zombie, because that's a definite bad thing. Oh, you can get more energy by eating. Ah, that makes so much sense. Very sensible. I like it. Right, we'll ditch the regular flowers and the spring onions. Hopefully, tomorrow, we can plant more wonderful seeds. Day 4. So we've got day 5 coming up. We'll check the television before bedtime. No, same old, same old. Let's check the weather, though. It's sunny. Ah, poop. And into bed. Go to sleep for the night? Why, yes, I think I shall. $28 gold. They're not worth much, are they? God, I hope the parsnips are worth more than $20 gold when they get pulled out. That's going to be annoying if they're not. Okay, what's the weather tomorrow? It is a beautiful sunny day. And then the fortune teller says today is neutral. Meh. Actually, was there a... No. Okay. Ah! Harvest time! Let's see how much we can get for these bad boys. Yay! Advancement. As you gain experience, you'll discover new crafting recipes to increase profit and make life easier. A scarecrow, for example, will prevent crows from snacking on your precious crops. Robin, the local carpenter, lives north of the town. In exchange for raw materials and money, she'll construct new buildings on your farm. You'll need her to build a coop, a barn, or barn, so that you can raise animals. If you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on the tilled soil to sow a crop. Water every day until the crop is ready for harvest. There we go. Harvest acquired. And I've got a few more people to discover. Okay.
Let the harvesting begin!
Nice. Good. Okay, so we're going to want to get more seeds in there, aren't we? Let's see what letter we got.
To our valued Jojo Mart customers, our team members have removed the landslide caused by our drilling operation near the mountain lake. I'd like to remind you that our drilling operation is entirely legal, pursuant to Initiative 06101091, Jojo Cola Amendment. Responsible stewardship of the local environment is our top priority. We apologize for any inconvenience this accident may have caused. As always, we value your continued support and patronage. Morris, Jojo Customer Satisfaction Representative.
Should have given him that creepy voice. Oh well. You know what? I'm going to sell these straight at the shop and get the money immediately and buy more seeds. Because we've got a big empty garden there. And we need to fill those slots.
It's efficiency, you know. Pure and simple. Efficiency.
That's right. It was Harvest Frenzy. Here we go. Let's find out what our crops are worth. Oh, there's something on the notice board. 2 days to Lewis's birthday. We have to figure out what he wants. Looking for a buddy to bring me a Jojo Cola. Sam. Sure, let's accept the quest. We can get a Jojo Cola from the Jojo Mart, so we should be okay. There might be one in the bar. Oh, come on. Locked? Seriously? Seriously? These people never throw anything out, do they? It's outrageous. How do the homeless people live round here? Good grief. Let's go down to the beach and see what we can find. Ah, a clam. Good.
Clam?
Nope. Everything's gone. Do I eventually end up being able to pick up this driftwood, or is it just for decoration? Ah, no more clams. We are clamless. Dum-de-dum. It's nowhere near opening time yet. We still got to pootle around looking for someone or something to do. Well, someone to talk to or something to do, obviously. That's not do people. Anything in the museum bin? No. May as well meet the guy in the museum, actually, seeing as we've not met everybody yet. What's this guy all about?
Hello there. Welcome to the Stardew Valley Archaeological Office. This is embarrassing, but the previous curator made off with the entire collection. We don't have any artifacts for display. But I'm hoping to remedy that soon. Hey, if you find any artifacts or minerals out there, would you let me know? Sure, guy.
Okay, let's not read that again. There we go. Let's see what this is all about.
There's a book missing here.
Okay. So we have to replace a few books. That's good news. And then, what have we got over here? Oh, a teddy bear. Whoa! Careful there, scoundrel. You don't want to side the teddy bear. That won't do you any good. The friendly little slime. Oh, lots of books. Calico Desert Flora and Fauna. Can't pick the teddy bear up, which is annoying, but never mind. A History of the Gotoro Empire. There's a book missing here. Oh, lots of missing books. There's a book missing here. Okay, let's head out. The shop should be open by now, so we can go and sell our lovely parsnips and see what kind of profit planting parsnips yields. Let's talk to her.
If you dig in the dirt, you can find some interesting things. That is so true. So true. I've spoken to that kid already, haven't I? Let's speak to him again. Oh no! Mum's making lentil soup tonight! That's a disaster. An absolute disaster. Never mind, though. Could be worse. She could be making soup out of her own feces. There are crazy people about, you know. Hey, what's up, farmer guy? Oh, I almost forgot. It's my day for doing push-ups. Every time I do push-ups, I try to do one more than last time. Pretty cool strategy, huh? Yeah, I suppose. Can we play catch? No. Ooh, you can go down people's mail as well. That seems a bit rude. Hello, Pierre. You can accept my first harvest. Let's have a look. 525. Well, what is that? 757? I'm not sure how much profit that is. Huh. Anyway, let's have a look. What can we get next? Something a bit more expensive should yield something a bit better, right? I don't know. I'm going to buy some kale. Because I feel like I've got to see what it is. Maybe some more cauliflowers? 12 days, blimey. That's a slow going harvest. I'll get some more potatoes. And a couple more bean starters. Sod it, we might as well get some cauliflowers. And then one more bean starter, taking us down to 7 gold remaining. Okay, let's get these in the ground. No time to waste. 15 gold profit. That's a bit of an investment for very little profit, to be honest. Won't be going back to parsnips again. I think what we need, almost certainly, is the beans, because they're going to be multi-crop harvest. Right, let's plant these here, here, and here, and then we can whack potatoes all the way around. Actually, one of those wasn't a potato. I think I just put a cauliflower there. No, these are cauliflowers. They were all potatoes. Don't be daft, scoundrel. Okay, and then what was that again? Kale, that was it. There we go. 3 lots of kale. The shell can go in the chest for sale tonight. There we go. Now I've leveled up. Oh, I didn't level up farming, did I? Or did I? Let's check to see if I can build anything else. Anything popped up in my crafting menu? Oh yeah, the field snack and the wild seeds. What do I need? Wild horseradish, daffodil, leek, and dandelion. Seems like quite an investment for something that might not actually grow into something that valuable. I mean, most of those things are worth like 50 gold apiece. That's a lot to turn up. Or turn down, rather. Okay, we'll start here. Whoa, what happened there? I skipped square. Okie dokie. So basically on those parsnips, you make 1 gold profit per planted parsnip. That's crazy. Them's some slim margins. Now I know why people don't carry on being farmers. They all quit. They don't all quit, obviously, otherwise we'd have no farmers, but you know what I mean. And here we go. Nearly done. Yay! Watering complete. It's a shame there's nothing to go in there, but never mind. Not much can be done. Okay. Okay, you get 10 seeds out of them. That isn't bad. Let's go buy a... Oh, I haven't got enough money for a Joja Cola. Oh. I've been a wastrel. Less a scoundrel, more a wastrel. Okay, we're going to head out and see if we can find anything. Hopefully, we'll find some decent forage. Let's head north this time. Oh, Lewis! Let's have a word with Lewis.
I hope things are going well on Farmbeard's farm. I'd hate to see it all dried up.
Well, it's pretty overgrown, but, you know, other than that, not much wrong. Can I get... these flowers up here really taunt me. I want them. Oh, hello. Not seen this area before. Who are you? It's Haley. That's the one Shin romanced on his videos. Oh, you're that new farmer boy, aren't you? I am. Huh? Oh, I'm Haley. If it weren't for those horrendous clothes, you might actually be cute. You're not put off by the tits? That's good. Pleased to know. I've just got to change my clothes. Okay, we've got a playground here. That's nice. Oh, and look. A nice, valuable flower. This might put us into the realm of being able to afford a Joja Cola to deliver. And look. Oh, I remember where I am now. Oh, hello. Calm down. Let's clear this out and see what we find inside. Anything? Ah, yeah. Mixed seeds. Plant those. Okay, that's good. Now we can discover... Hello, who's this in the garden? Hey, sorry if I seem cranky. I'm a little sore from work yesterday. Dare I ask what you do? I had to carry 10 boxes of medical files to the attic. I had to sort patient records for 4 hours straight. Oh, that's terrible. But not nearly as terrible as the things I was thinking you might have done for a living. Oh, wait, no, these flowers are accessible. But not pickable. Poo! Much poo. Hey, guy. Sebastian.
I don't really know you.
Okay, well, talking to me is a good way to get to know me. Look at that, I haven't even gone in the community centre. I fully intended to, but I've, oh, hello. No music. Let's have a chat with Robin. Have you met everyone in town yet? That sounds exhausting. Not yet, but this guy isn't on my list.
Demetrius. Greetings. I am Demetrius, local scientist and father. Thanks for introducing yourself.
Great.
I'm studying the local plants and animals from my home laboratory. Have you met my daughter Maru? She's interested to meet you.
I know. She seems very keen. She's a bit bummed out earlier, though, which is a shame. Let's have a quick peek over here, see if there's anything worth picking up. Nope. And it's 4:30. It's probably best to get down to the community centre, because I want to start gathering those forage things as soon as possible. It may even be too late for the spring forage collection. I might have to wait a whole year to do it again. Demetrius has got quite the strut on him, look. Doom, doom, doom. Really bowling along. It's locked. Oh man, the Pelican Town Community Centre's locked. Hey.
Lewis? Lewis! Lewis!
No. Doesn't matter how I call him, he just won't answer. Seem to have spoken to everybody. Ah. Oh, hello. Everyone's gathering. What's this? Shane.
Don't you have work to do?
Come on, man. Just because you work at Joja doesn't mean you have to be all surly. Or does it? I don't know.
Carolyn, it's a fine looking day.
That it is, Carolyn. That it is.
Worms? Where did I miss the worms? Oh, they're right next to me. Okay. On days like this, I like to help Evelyn with the public gardens. Excuse me. Just clicked on chat there by mistake. Okay, well, I'd like to hear about your works in the public gardens. I see worms, and I've got myself a rusty spoon.
You found an artifact. The creator of the local museum might want to know about this. She's strong for her age, but I think she appreciates all the help she can get.
Okay. Hello, Willy's marching around. He's not fishing. Willy, why aren't you grabbing the fish?
If you really want to get the fish biting, make sure you put some bait on your hook.
That was not my best pirate voice. But then again, they can't all be gold. They can't all be Pams.
Boo. Can I afford a Joja Cola? I seem to remember it was 70 gold or something ridiculous. 75 gold. You can stick that up your ass and then open it. Okay, what have we got down here? You meant other worms. Okay, there were other worms I missed. Never mind. No worms down here, though. They're easy to miss. You're not really paying attention to those worms, aren't they? Maybe I should head back sort of that direction-ish. See if I can find worms. Up by the old community centre. Maybe Lewis will be outside the community centre now. Were the worms up here? I can get Joja Cola from fishing. Maybe I should grab the fishing pole then. That kind of makes sense. Still locked. Can't get in there. Have I got a new... Ah, yes, I can hand this in at the museum.
You found an ancient-looking object. Could it be some kind of artifact from long ago? Perhaps Gunther, curator of the local museum, has the answer.
It looks to me like a rusty spoon. I don't think I'm going to get to the museum in time, am I? I can't actually remember where it is, thinking about it. Where's the museum? It's, Huh. Ah, museum. Open 8 till... Oh, it's already closed. No point going there now. After dark. Let's have a quick look in this one's post box. Let's see what's going on here. Nothing? No, can't go in there. Nothing in the bins either. Maybe someone will be in the bar. Let's have a look. Oh, wow. The joint's really jumping. Who's this?
It's Pierre. I've been working hard all week. I deserve a little relaxation on a Friday night.
Yes, you do.
I've been working hard... Wait, is it Friday? Oh, no, it's Sunday. Sunday is the Lewis's birthday, isn't it? Handling salty fish all day makes me real thirsty. The weather doesn't really matter to me. I typically stay near my shop all year round. Depressing, huh?
Not really. Aw, oh, look at that. Couple in love. Robin is busy. And so I'd imagine is Demetrius. They are. This guy's still not chit-chatting.
This is the youth section of the bar.
Hmm, if I give the cue ball a bit of a topspin, maybe I could... I'm not very good. Hmm, if I give the... blah blah. Hang on, let's have a word with her. It's Abigail. Oh, that's right. I heard someone new was moving into that old farm.
It's kind of a shame, really. I always enjoyed exploring those old overgrown fields by myself.
Well, you can still explore if you want. I'm not going to stop you. Just don't uproot my crops.
Come back.
He doesn't want to talk to me. There we go. No, that's Sam.
Ah, he's evaded.
Can I get a Joja Cola out of here?
75? No.
How is that the price of a Joja Cola? Seems outrageously expensive to me. What's this? This looks like what's her name out of Misery? Kathy Bates.
Marnie doesn't seem to notice that you're there.
Oh, come on. You're going to hog Lewis's time.
I've got municipal questions. Good evening, scoundrel. Oh, sorry. Good evening, scoundrel. I'm glad to see you relaxing at the saloon. It's good for you to take a break now and then. Your grandfather always worked himself too hard. I'll have an extra beer in his honour tonight.
It's good to know. Who's this over here, all on her own? That's no good. Leah.
It's simpler to be friends with the trees. They don't have much to say.
Oh, that's interesting.
Oi, Gus, give me another pint of your strongest.
Okay, that's all good. How do we find out who likes what? That's a good question. Shit, it's 10 o'clock and I still haven't planted my last seeds. Let's get moving. We've got to get our boots scooting. At the river. Okay, I've missed them. Ah, the ponds on the farm only give trash. That's pretty cool. Damn it, I can't see where I've planted crops or not. There we go. Okay, quickly get this stuff in the sail thing. Get out of there. Get into the damn house. There we go. Check for nighttime television. Nothing. Yep, I'm going to go to sleep for the night. Level 1 farming. Plus 1 watering can proficiency. Plus 1 hoe proficiency. New crafting recipe, scarecrow. New recipe, basic fertilizer. Lovely. So what have I gained today as profit? 80 gold foraging. And that's the lot. Everything. The 5th of spring, year 1. Okie dokie, bright and early, what's on the telly? The weather report tomorrow is a beautiful sunny day again. And the fortune teller says, very displeased to do. They will do their best to make my life difficult. Well, start as you mean to go on. Let's water everything first. Get that out of the way. Do, 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 do. Man, that went out of tune pretty badly. Got a good load of beans here. I think we're going to end up with quite a large... Oh, hello. What's that? Oh, it's a high-quality parsnip. We'll put that in the chest and save it, I think. Boo. Go water, water. There we go. Okay, everything's watered. Let's put what we want to keep in here, and we'll keep the spoon, and we'll take it to Gunther. Oopsie-daisy, wrong button. I did water everything, didn't I? Yeah, I got everything good. Okay, so we're probably not going to find much forage, are we, if the spirits are actively attempting to stop us. Silver star is medium quality, gold star is high quality. Okay, maybe I'll set it. Ah! Finally! Cutscene. Oh, Lewis is unhappy. Poor old Lewis.
Oh, hi there. What an eyesore. This is the Pelican Town Community Centre. Or what's left of it, anyway. It used to be the pride and joy of the town, always bustling with activity. Now, just look at it. It's shameful. These days, the young folk would rather sit in front of the TV than engage with the community. But listen to me, I sound like an old fool. Jojo Corporation has been hounding me to sell them the land so they can turn it into a warehouse. Pelican Town could use the money, but there's something stopping me from selling it. I guess old-timers like me get attached to relics of the past. Ah, well. If anyone else buys a Jojo Corporation membership, I'm just going to go ahead and sell it. Oh, don't do that. Yeah, let's go inside.
Let's do it. Let's head into the Pelican Town Community Center.
Huh? What's this? I guess Vincent and Jez must have been playing in here. This place is even more dilapidated than I remember.
Pop! Ooh, green thing.
What? What's the matter? Are you ill? You saw something. I wouldn't be surprised if this place was full of rats.
What?
Ooh la la. Zut alors, mon dieu.
You're worrying me, scoundrel. Look, I think I'm going to head home. I need some lunch.
Cool.
Hey, I'll keep this place unlocked from now on. Maybe you can help catch that rat if you have some extra time.
Maybe I do. Maybe strange. I'll have to come back and explore this building further. Sure, we'll do. Let's do it now. Let's find out what I'm supposed to be foraging. Oh, hello. We've got an extremely urgent F. There's something odd going on in the community centre. That there is. That there is. What's this doodah? Nothing. None of this stuff counts. Let's have a look over here. There's a bulletin board. A big old safe. A nice furnace room. What's on the other side? Let's have a look. Any forage? That would be nice. Oh, well, thank you, Super Chaser. Super Chaser, sorry. Oh, hello! A little thingamajig. A doodah.
Blip. Then up and yet, certain fortin yet, wooden yet, and from quarten. Zero from the burden. Did first and sit no more near you had yet in the garden from sword. See it first, not the garden, from wheat and water, yeah, love. Wooden it and spot and sit out and food. Wooden yet nip and yard and yard and wood out and chat yet and yet and one out and that and you would need and did out and sit that. Tip, zap up and yet, dab up and up and good and yard and yard. No, I don't think I can read it. Nigga, whoop. Okay, well, we'll come back to that. We'll figure out what that means at a later date. Hopefully it's just some simple replacement cipher, but maybe not. No? We missed everything? Is that it? Am I allowed to take the book? What happens here? Has to be said, I'm slightly confused. I thought there would be more information forthcoming, but apparently not. Let's get out of here. Maybe the house. Yeah? Maybe up here? Anything here? No? Display cabinet? Okay, we've seen the whole place. We'll come back another time. Ah, still only 10:20 a.m. We've got 87 gold. And a bad luck day. Ah, we're going off to the museum, aren't we? So basically head south until you get... No, just south down here and then cross the river. That's the way we're going to go. Cross by the Joja Mart. Fuck you, Joja Mart. You corporate bastards. Past the blacksmith. Here we go, our first artifact handed in after a quick rummage through the museum bins. Nothing. Fair enough. Oh, we got a cutscene. I mean, this guy's hat alone should warrant him a voice, but I just can't seem to think one. Abysmal. Not a single piece in the entire collection. What's this? You found something! Let's see it! It's a rusty spoon. Remarkable! It's very old. I'd love to study this in greater detail, but it is yours. Nah, keep it, mate. I've got a favour to ask you. Would you consider donating any new artifacts or minerals that you find? We could make a groundbreaking discovery together. Oh, and who knows? If you keep donating, I might come across some interesting items to send your way. Okay, sounds good to me. Think about it, will you? If you decide to donate, just bring the objects to the front desk. Sure, no problem. And
speaking of which, there you go. Let's pop the spoon. Here, first thing you see as you come in. And that's the journal updated. Nice. Let's have a little look at what the journal has to say for itself. Archaeology. Gunther asked if you'd consider donating any new artifacts or minerals you find to the museum. He says he'll compensate you by way of occasional rare goods. Oh wait, we got to get that Joja Cola sold, haven't we? I better go and buy a Joja Cola. Don't want to miss up on the opportunity to deliver it. Actually, who am I delivering it to? Sam. Is he the sports guy? I ain't buying no Joja Cola from Joja Mart. I'm supporting my local businesses. I'm going to the pub. Is this guy Sam? I think he's Sam, right? No, he's Alex. My arms are really sore, but that's the sign of progress for a guy like me. I must have done 1,000 push-ups yesterday. What's he going to do 1,001 today, I presume? I find Sam? Does anybody know? Are you kidding me? The one time this place is empty and oh, it's a vending machine anyway. Doesn't matter. Let's get that Joja Cola. Yeah. Now all we need to do is locate Sam. Sam. Samuel, Sam, Sammy, Sam, Sam. Are you Sam? Let's see. Hi. Nope, he's Vincent. Dad's coming back soon. I hope he brings me some toys. Let me guess, prison? This is such a small town. You can't avoid meeting everyone. I wonder what it's like to live in the city. Yeah, it's alright. You smell like grass.
Shh! Shut up!
There could be police nearby.
Oh!
Oh, yes, of course. You mean grass, yes. Let's have another little crackle at the community centre. Oh, hello. Oh, no, it's what's her face. Hayley. I'm feeling an urge to go shopping. Ugh, I wish there was a mall here. Shut up. We don't need no Joja Mall. Who is Sam and where does he live?
Who is your Samuel and what does he do?
Should we have another look at the little, do I have to catch this bad boy? Still none the wiser. Nobody here. Does it tell you whose house is whose? It's Pierre's, Mayor's house, Blacksmith, Elliot's cabin, Emily and Haley, Jody Kent and Sam. Okay, that's where we've got to go. We might have to hang around there all day to meet him, but whatever. Seems doable, right? Oops, don't do that. I want to just shake it. You can't shake that tree.
Huh. Bit of a disappointment.
Oh, hello, we've got a gathering of people here. Have I met all of you before? It's Jody.
Oh, you aren't exactly how I imagined, but that's okay. I'm Jody. It's a quiet little town, so it's very exciting when someone new moves in. Having a farmer around could really change things. Haven't you already got a farm over there?
I thought Leah had a farm.
Is it just me, or does Abigail have an unhealthy interest in doom and gloom?
I don't know, can't remember.
Maybe I'm just too old to understand.
Maybe you are. Oh, hello. You're new.
Why, hello, and welcome to our little community, dear. You can call me Granny if you like.
Oh. Thank you, Granny. Granny? Hey, Willie, you coming to see Granny?
If the local fishing scene got a bit more lively, I might expand the shop stock.
Okay. I'll be sure to fish as and when I get the opportunity, but I'm not carrying my pole at the moment, so... Ah, hello, this looks good. What's going on here? Can we come in?
You're not good enough friends with Sam to enter his bedroom.
I see. You've got to be... good friends, have we? Okay. Lovely bit of water there. Oh my god, it's gone midnight. We're going to have to wrap this up soon, I think. It's been a 2-hour Stardew Valley stream, but you know what? I've genuinely enjoyed this quite a lot. It's it might become the Friday game after Dark Souls. I can't play Rimbeards and Farmbeards at the same time though, can I? That's pure self-indulgence. I bet I miss him. Just gonna have a quick look to see if I can find any forage over here, and then we'll head back and see if he's come out of his bedroom. It's 4:00 PM. I love to decorate for the different seasons. Good to know. Thanks for telling me. I appreciate the knowledge. Got 262 gold. I really should buy some more seeds. Oh well. Going on a little worm hunt. Not seeing anything. Let's head back and see if Sam's left his bedroom. Then we can hand over the Joja Cola. And profit, I believe, is the sequence of events. Here we go. Nice long walk. Scoundrel Farm must go on. It will. It will. Don't worry. I'm going to return to this. I've, for some reason, I thought this wouldn't be a good game to stream, but I don't know why I thought that. But yeah, it is. I enjoy it. And you all seem to be still here, so that's a good sign. I say you all, I only know by who's talking at the moment. There could be other people viewing. Who knows, I may have suddenly gained 1 billion viewers. Highly unlikely, but possible. It's set to the news station. Good. Oh, hello, we've got someone up here. Who's this? Not interested in talking. Whoa, look at that slow breathing. That really is quite paced. Come on, guys, you can't stay in there all afternoon. Ah, here we go. Here we go. Who first? It's Sam. Hello, Sam. I just remembered that I was meaning to do something, but I forgot. What? I didn't hear you. I'm busy thinking about something. What do you want? This happens to me all the time. Okay, let's get this cola and let's... There we go. Hey, thanks a million, Scoundrel. I should have known you'd be the one to take this job. Hooray, we got a bonus. Let's have a look. 75 gold. The exact same price as a Joja Cola. Okay, that's a bit disappointing. No profit, but at least he's happy. We've cheered him up. We've given him a little bit, something to smile about. Okay, what to do? Let's go buy some seeds. Seems to be the sensible decision. Maybe we'll build a scarecrow. Oh, come on, let me buy stuff. Come back when Pierre's tending the shop. Pierre, your opening hours specifically say now. If you find any wild produce, I'll take it off your hands for a reasonable price. That's cool, but could you please get into the old... Come on! Move! Not that way. No, go behind your desk. Go behind the desk. Go behind the counter. Go behind the... You fuckeroon. Or am I misinterpreting his hours? Is he supposed to be shut? Why can't I read this? What the hell is going on? Oh my god, it's Lewis's birthday. I don't even know what he likes. Okay, for some reason I can't read this sign on the door, but never mind. It's getting late. Let's head back, see what we can do with our energy. Spend a bit. Oh god, I'm tempted to do just one more day, but definitely this has to be the final day of this session. It's getting late. It's 8 minutes past midnight according to my PC. What does my phone say? Well, it says 1 minute to midnight. Maybe I could squeeze in another day. Yeah. Decisions, decisions, decisions. Let's grab our crafting gear and see if we can make a scarecrow. Actually, I could sell this. Yeah, let's sell that stuff. None of it's gold star. Oh, hang on. We've run out of space. Is the clay... Let's see what we can craft. Ooh. Basic fertilizer requires sap. Ooh, nice. Oh, make some of that. Let's save up the sap then. Wood, coal, and fibre. We've only got one piece of coal, but I think it's worth it to protect our crops. And we got a chief for it. That's good. Build some fertiliser. How much sap have I got? Loads. We're going to build up on that. Stock up on it. Right, that means the wood, the clay, the fertiliser, and the stone and fibre can go back in. But all these starred produce can come out and be sold for mega booty. Huge bucks. There we go. What have we got here? Advancement. As you gain experience, you'll discover new crafting recipes to increase profit and make life easier. A scarecrow, for example, will prevent crows from snacking on your precious crops. Good. Let's place this bad boy. I think we're going to place it in amongst the high-yield beans. Makes sense to me. There we go. That keeps the should keep the crows away. I could build a fence around here, you know. That makes sense. Chop down another tree or two. Slide that out of the way. It's a big old waste of a health bar if I don't actually just use some of it up. There we go. Oh, more rocks to be smashed. Still got half energy. 10 o'clock though, don't want to get caught out in the field. One more tree, then we're done. Oh, the pad's plugged in. I keep hearing like a feeling the table vibrate when I'm doing this, thinking, what the hell's causing that? We've got rats running around. No, it's not rats, it's my pad. Of course. Let's put this stuff in there, and then, bomb, 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 bomb. Oh, a maple seed. Ah, keep that. Check for nighttime telly. Nothing, and then into bed. 6th of spring, year one. Farming, 43 gold. Foraging, 137, and that leads up to 180 gold total income. Nice. We already had a few hundred as well. Yay! The first week is ending. Let's get out of bed and see what's happening. Weather report. Tomorrow is going to be partially cloudy with a light breeze. Expect lots of pollen. Oh, great. Hope my game guy isn't actually allergic to pollen. The spirits are in good humour today. I think you'll have a little extra luck. Good. And the Queen of Sauce, greetings. It is I, the Queen of Sauce, here to teach you a new mouth-watering recipe from my secret cookbook. This week's dish, stir-fry. It's a perfect way to get some healthy greens on your plate. Sauté the greens in a little sesame oil and make sure to add plenty of fresh ginger and garlic. Now breathe deeply. Oh, that's good. You learned how to cook stir-fry. Hooray! Oh, I've got a letter and everything. Let's have a look. My sources tell me you've been poking around inside the old community centre. Why don't you pay me a visit? My chambers are west of the forest lake in the stone tower. I may have information concerning your rat problem. M. Rasmodius, wizard. Well, how can I refuse an offer like that? What the hell's this? That's better. Okay, we'll water this lot. And then off to see Rasmus Modius, whatever his name is. Or, it only saves when... Does it save when you quit, or does it only save when you sleep? Because if it only saves when I sleep, it might be worth me just quitting now. Oh, boy. Oh, hello, that was harvestable. Ah, if I put the scarecrow there... That's alright, I can harvest. Or water, rather. It's all good. Bah! Harvestable kale? It's not even kale, so yeah, it's not harvestable kale. go. I've got another notification. What's all this about? It's getting very busy, isn't it? The notifications are flying thick and fast. Meet the wizard. You received a letter from the local wizard. He claims to have information regarding the old community centre. You know what? I have to call it time. It's too late. I've got work in the morning. I have to stop. Much as I would love to continue playing this for hours and hours and hours, it cannot be. So, with that in mind, I shall turn back on my webcam and bid you, the YouTube viewer, adieu, goodbye, adios, sayonara, auf Wiedersehen. There's probably other words in the world for goodbye, but I can't think of any right now, not off the top of my head. So anyway, if you enjoyed this, like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you want to see more. Or if you don't, I suppose you could also leave a comment, but that's probably opening me up to some awful abuse. But anyway, thank you for watching. It's been a genuine pleasure to record for you, and I hope to see you in the next episode, or an episode of something else. Who knows what's going to happen? Anything is possible. Not literally, the laws of physics must be obeyed, but anything within that remit is possible. Thank you for watching.